What's up, Yapa fam, and welcome to today's TOTD. Today's TOTD is going to be a deep one. It's going to be very deep. We're going to be talking about disobeying God. Disobeying God. Now, I'm sure every single one of you guys have come to a point and a time in your life where you knew that you did not obey what the Holy Ghost told you to do. I'll be transparent, tell you guys that I've done that. And then I go pray and ask God for his mercy and to help me with that test again. But here's a life that I don't know if we think about too often, about disobeying God. Sometimes I just think that we just don't do it. We don't even think about it. So let's go back over 2017 years ago, back to when there was a storm. There was a great storm, in fact. It wasn't just a normal storm, but it was a great storm. And the waves were crashing, and the waves were like getting all crazy. And there were 12 men on a boat, and they were getting frightened. They were trying to get across the water. And all of a sudden, they see what looked to be a spirit walking towards them on top of the water. And so they do what any normal person would do.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Did you see that? Did you see that?
Just what any normal person would have done. And then that voice says, "Don't be afraid, I'm your friend." And them 12 men in the boat must have been like,
"A friend? Why does he go with friend?"
And then that friend told him his name, Jesus of Nazareth. And one of the dudes in the boat was like, "Hey, if that's really you, Jesus, let me come unto you on the water." And then Jesus answers his prayer and tells him to come. And how much is that like us? We pray, "God, I want to see the miraculous. God, I want to do something great for the kingdom. I want to make you proud, Jesus. Yes." We pray those prayers, and then he says, "Okay, come," in the form of telling you something to do that scares you. Yes, 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 yes. Well, you're kind of a little about doing something. He says, "Okay, you said you want to see the miraculous? Here's someone in a wheelchair at Walmart. Pray for them." Ooh. "You said you want to be a soul winner? There's a group of a few teenagers that are smoking. Go witness to them." "You said you wanted to see massive revival and massive outpouring of the Holy Ghost? Go knock on every single door in your neighborhood. Get the names of the people that live there and pray for them for the next 3 months." "Oh, but God, you know, he looks comfortable in that wheelchair. I don't want to disturb him. He's busy at Walmart." Oh, now God, there's just a little bit of a problem. Secondhand smoke, you know, it's not the will of the Lord that my lungs be burned out, so I'm gonna use, you know what I'm saying? Oh, now God, you know that the family just across the way from us, they blast their music like 24/7, all loud. It makes the dishes in my house and my kitchen thump. They thump so loud. And all of those little voices kind of just like, towards the voice of God. Now, let's take it a step further and let's talk about how it applies to us as young apostolics doing great things. You know, we pray those prayers and God answers us with a dream, a vision, a goal. You know, start this, start that, do this, do that. And it's a phenomenal idea, a mind-blowing idea, but it scares us. Why? Well, God, if you call me to start this, how am I going to get that? How am I going to connect with these people? How am I going to get them to accept me? You're calling me to be an entrepreneur, but how do I even start? I have this great idea, but where do I begin? You're calling me to be a prayer warrior, but nobody in my youth group prays. And if I start praying, I'm gonna get louder than all of them, and then all the eyes won't be on me. God, if you're calling me to walk up into this hospital and pray for every single individual here, what if they don't want me to pray? What if I get kicked out? What if the nurses say, like, "Hey, no, you can't be in here," and they like give me the boot? Or what if they just don't get healed? Scared. But yet he told us to come. It was our decision to pray those prayers, our decision to join the church, our decision to make this life our life. So really, Yapa fam, we have two choices. Either do what he's calling us to do or not do what he's calling us to do. Now, Yapa fam, the decision is quite obvious. Yes, it's gonna be scary. Yes, you're not gonna wanna do it. It may even be awkward at first. All these hindrances, all these mental roadblocks stopping you from experiencing what God wants you to experience. But, and I'll end today's TOTD on this note, what are you going to do? If you guys like the message of today's TOTD, if you kind of are thinking of kind of along the lines of what you're going to do with the previous question asked, go ahead and comment down below. I would like to know. I know my answer. At least I hope to know my answer. answer in the time when he says to call. Now, if this video was helpful to you, go ahead and slap, crush, smash that like button down below. Then go ahead and crush, smash, slay that little arrow that lets you share out to other people so you can let everyone know about this little community here on YouTube, here on everywhere actually. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, Google Play, Google Plus, all them other places, iTunes, etc., etc. This little community of young apostolics are looking to do something radically apostolic in today's society with the power and the strength of the 21st century. Go ahead and let everyone know about it. Your youth pastor needs to know about it. Your pastors need to know about it. Your young people need to know about it. Everybody needs to know about it. So let's make that happen. God bless you guys. In Jesus' name, I love you all. Be apostolic. Above all, be apostolic, because that'll get you to heaven. And I'll catch you guys in tomorrow's TOTD. Love you guys.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing? You see the same thing?